Do you think you are meant to do more? Do you want to help people? Maybe you want to do good in the world. I was like that, and I figured out what to do about it. I built my own business to serve others, and now I have thousands of people I do that for. If you're interested in starting your own spiritual business and want to know how to get customers, in this episode, I'll tell you how I did it.
Welcome to Between Heaven and Earth, an internet radio talk show where we help you connect spirit and divine guidance. Lisa Kay, your host, brings you shows that can enhance and transform your life with tips and new ideas for more happiness, abundance, and better relationships. Lisa is an expert on intuition and can show you how to strengthen your inner guidance to empower yourself. Each show is positive and uplifting to inspire your day. Her guest speakers are specialists on self-help, positive thinking, spirituality, and conscious living. Be the best that you can be with Between Heaven and Earth, conscious living for your soul.
So maybe you're going to work and you find your heart's not in it. Or maybe you're longing to do something that's worthwhile and you want to make a difference in the world. There's so many of us who are like this, and I'm probably not any different. Way back when, before I was doing what I'm doing today, I worked in corporate. I actually built software. I loved technology and I loved managing a team. And that's what I did for many years. Now, I was leading a large team of 70 software developers to build a huge software application. We were an outside consulting company hired to create this application for an insurance company. And one day, a couple of my project leads came into my office and said, "Why are we doing this? We all know they're just going to throw the software we're making in the garbage." Well, it wasn't because our software was bad. In fact, it was the best application this company ever had. The software we built had been tested and audited, and it worked perfectly. But I knew they would never use it in the end. Why? Because of politics. We were caught in the middle of a turf war between two warring groups in the company. The end users were on one side and the technology group on the other. And the end users were never going to use the software that the technology group built, purely because they were bickering. But we were hired to build the software for the technology group. And so we did. And $9 million worth of software then went into the garbage. I hated that. It was a huge project. The politics and the bureaucracy was horrible. And I had to navigate it all so we could, quote, win in the end by not getting tainted by their battles. And we did win in the end. The software was completed and it passed audit with flying colors. It was even better than what they had before. But it felt hollow to me. And that was when I decided I wanted to do something that was going to be helpful in the world, that was going to do some good, be constructive. Because I put a lot of sweat and energy into my work. I always do. And I want my efforts to be put to good use. So I decided to start my own business. So I started my spiritual business back in 2008. And I really wanted to be online starting in 2009. Of course, as you know, because I have that technical background, I thought, wow, this is great. I can reach more people, the technology is something I know and love, I can teach online, and it's so easy to put it together and then be available, and people can access it 24/7, and I can build it, and they can use it anytime. How wonderful is that? Well, as I started my business and put things in place, I actually struggled for a long time until I discovered some secrets. And I want to share with you some of those today. Now, what happened was, after I discovered those secrets, I doubled my income in 1 year. And I've had steady growth ever since. And now I have a team of people who support both me and my business. And we work together to serve others. I am here doing my dream job. I love what I do. And I love that I can help people, and that I watch the fruits of my labor and certainly my team as we work together to help others help themselves to live a better life. Now, what could be better than that? you're doing what you love, you are out there working and knowing that every minute of the day that you are putting your energy and your life's effort into some work, that it's going to actually do something for someone else and help them. So that to me is a win-win rather than a lose-lose like that software was that I built for that insurance company. And so as I realized, okay, you know, with every business, and there's some of you out there, I'm sure, who are thinking about starting your own business and how do I get going? I know there are a bunch of my own customers and my own students who are looking to start their healing business or their intuitive consulting business, or they might want to do something that uses products to help other people. And so I've been getting a lot of questions, and I know some of you out there may be interested in this. So I wanted to share with you some of the lessons that I learned, some of the most important ones. Of course, I learned a lot of lessons, and I'm still learning, but things are finally coming together and working so well for me. And I love this. And one of the things, as you guys know, that I do is I love to share. My passion is to learn and to help my life get better and better with the things that I learn. And then when it works for me, I want to share it with you. I want to share it with other people to help them improve their lives. And that's what this podcast is all about, to uplift you and to help you with your life. So if you're interested in knowing how do you get customers for your spiritual business or your own, someone had written me on Instagram asking about a business she wants to do. It's not, quote, necessarily spiritual, but it's about something that she wants to do in helping people learn how to, I believe it's to learn English for Greek-speaking people or learn Greek for English-speaking people. So it doesn't matter what it is, but these are applicable as well. So here are the three things. Number one, start small. Don't try to do everything. One of the things that I found my followers and my people who are in the small business area want to do, especially if you want to be a healer or you want to be a spiritual business, you try to do everything. And that just dilutes the clarity for your customer. It confuses people because they're not really quite sure of what you do. And in that case, a confused customer never buys. So, and that's it in a nutshell. So you want to start small. Don't try to do everything. Try to do one thing at first, because it doesn't mean you're going to throw the other things away. I've seen people, and you see this still, where they want to do, let's say, tarot card readings, and they want to do essential oils, and they want to do energy healing and all these kinds of meditation, and they wrap it all up and they say they do all these things and they put it out there, and then they don't always see success because it's not clear what they do or what they're good at or what they're the specialist in. I had heard a really nice analogy, which is if you go into a drugstore and you have a headache, and if there was a bottle of pills that was on the shelf that said it was medicine, that's probably not the one you're going to pick. You probably want to look for the bottle that says pain relief for headaches, right? So that's the way people think. So you want to start small. Now, again, that doesn't mean that you are going to throw the other things away, because maybe you have that one thing that you do that you tell everybody, but then when they come to see you, let's see if we could pick one. Let's say you do Reiki. There are a lot of people who do Reiki out there. And you also like to do essential oils. So that's one thing you could do. So if you really love Reiki and the energy healing, say, a little more than the essential oils, then do that. Put that out there. And if you have a client that comes to you and they say, you know, I need some help in going to sleep or relaxing, say, hey, you know what? I have some solutions in terms of some essential oils that can help you relax. and that becomes your what they would call like a back-end product or an upsell. So you don't have to throw the other things away. And those of you who are my students and my customers, you know that this is my business model, is that I teach everyone how to become more intuitive, develop your intuition, but I also have other things that I teach as well. And that's what we call on the back end. So number one, start small. Don't try to do everything. What do you love the most? And pick that and put that out front. Number two, business success is all about testing and trying. You don't need to have it all built first. So oftentimes people think, okay, I have to build my whole store and I've got to have my website and my e-store and I have to have all these bells and whistles all put in place before I actually can go out and find a customer. And you don't need to have it built all first. And that's what I did. I did this the wrong way. I actually built a 60-hour video developing your intuition first level course, which was very expensive. And it turned out that that was not what I needed to do. And that took a lot of time, and it would for you. So before you could actually go out to find a customer. So what you need to do is to test first. So you may, what I actually do is I actually go out and I test the market, or I might talk about it first, or I might even market a product before I have the whole thing built out. Now, it doesn't mean that I don't have anything, but it just means that I'm starting, and we're going to do it as kind of like a beta and a test, and we start to test and see and try something out, something small, and see how it does in the market. So that's number one. Number one was start small. Number two is testing and trying. And number three is, well, it uses a word a lot of people don't like. And the word is marketing. I can't even say it. It's marketing. It's kind of like the word meditation. Sometimes when people hear, oh, meditation, I can't meditate. Forget it. You know, I'm leaving. Marketing is similar in that people go, oh, I don't want to market, you know, I don't want to sell. That's icky. That's sleazy. That's pushy. But what we need to understand is what marketing really is. It's really about sharing your message with a potential customer of what it is that you want to do to help them. And it's also all about why you do what you are doing. What is it that you are standing for? Why do you do this? And how you're going to help others get to where they want. Help them solve a problem or help them do what you did, which is improve your life. Generally, that's why we do this, right? We want to help other people improve their life or their situation or their problems. So that's really what it's about. And there's certainly a lot more about marketing and selling and messaging that I learned that I can share with you, but we're not going to do it in the podcast today. But those are the three things that are really important. Number one, start small. Don't try to do everything. Number two, business is always about testing and trying. That's how you become successful. And number three, marketing is important. So if you are interested in this subject, you know, if you're interested in starting, say, a side hustle, your own business or spiritual business, I would love to hear from you. Let me know. You can catch me on Instagram, or you can catch me on Facebook. And the best way to do that is to go, if you're going to Instagram, I'll give you my handle, which is LisaK888 on Instagram. And let me know, just send me a DM. Let me know if you're interested, because this is another thing I'm passionate about, and my success, I want to be your success, and I'll share with you all the secrets that I know. You can also go to my website and find out more about me or how to get me on social media at lmk88.com. So I am Lisa Kay, and you've been listening to Between Heaven and Earth Radio, Conscious Living for Your Soul. Thanks for listening, everybody.